everyone. Good day, children. How are you all? I think you are all fine. So welcome to our EduHunt online classes. So I hope these classes are very useful for you, especially in this period. So these are the very useful classes for you if you follow our website, so EduHunt, so and EduHunt YouTube channel also. So today I would like to discuss one very very important chapter, but you will tell me what is that chapter after discussing some examples here. So for suppose if a child go to bookshop, if he want to buy all the books regarding his particular class, for example that boy wants to buy 6th class textbooks, so then how he will communicate with the bookseller? He will go to bookshop and he will ask him, he will ask the bookseller, sir, can you give me 6th class books? Then immediate reply from the bookseller is, so all the books or any separate books like math book or science book, like that he will ask. Then you will say, then that the student will say all the books, because he want all the academic books regarding his particular class. So then there all is there, na, for that one important term is there, that term I will introduce here. Otherwise, one some woman, if she go to shop, she want to buy Pooja things, he will ask the merchant, hello sir, can you please give me Pooja things for me? Then he will ask that lady, any particular items or all? Then based on the requirement, then that woman ask that merchant, if she want all, then she will use one particular term. Otherwise, if she want only one or two things from that all, then she will say what are the required things. Otherwise, if some boys went to buy all cricket things which are required to play, then they will use one term. What is that term? So after listening to all these things, I think you would get what is the chapter that we are going to discuss today. So yes, that chapter is nothing but sets. So I said one example, when a 6th class boy or 7th class boy went to bookshop, how he will ask, sir, can you please give me all set of 6th class textbooks? Or a 7th class boy went there, means he will ask, sir, could you please give me all 7th class textbooks? Like that he will ask. Otherwise, if a woman go to a shop and if she wants to buy all Pooja things which are required, then she will ask, can you please give me a set of Pooja things to do Pooja at home? And if some group of people went to buy some cricket kit, we'll call it as, otherwise set of things which are required to play cricket. So these are all, we'll call them as a set of things. Then what is the actual definition of set? The definition of set is a collection of well-defined objects. Collection of well-defined objects is called as a set. What do you mean by well-defined objects? So before that, what is an object? So regarding mathematics, we'll consider all the living things and non-living things in the universe, we'll consider them as objects. So coming to set definition, a collection of well-defined objects are called as a set. So what do you mean by well-defined? So means when you talk about a thing, we should be in a position to judge whether that object is belong to the given set or not. For example, examples for objects, a chair, is an object, and camera is an object, this board is an object, and we can consider, for example, I am an object, I am a living thing. And all these are comes under objects in mathematics. So we discussed about a term well defined. What do you mean by well defined? Well defined means if we talk about well defined objects, so that object we should say about that object whether that object is belongs to the given set or not. We should be in a position to say whether that object is belong to the given set or not. So if we are able to say whether that is belonging or doesn't belong, then we can say that is a well defined. So examples for sets. All the natural numbers. Less than 10, which are less than 10. So all the natural numbers which are less than 10 means, well, what are those numbers, Nanna? Natural number starts from 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So all these will come under less than 10. So when there is a word less than, you should not include that number. Before that number you have to write. So all the natural numbers which are less than 10. So here, so all these are 1 to 9 are well defined objects. We can say that all the numbers from 1 to 9 are well defined. They will be under this set. Okay na? So what is this set, Nana? So what are the numbers we will get in this set? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And one more example. Vowels in English alphabet. So vowels in English alphabet. What are the vowels in English alphabet, Nana? How many vowels are there? There will be 5 vowels. Those are A, E, I, O, U. A, E, I, O, U. Next, one more example. Prime numbers. So prime numbers means what, Nana? The numbers which are having only two factors, those two are 1 and that number itself. So those kind of numbers less than 10, so we have to write here. So those are 2, 3, 5, 7. So 2, 3, 5, 7 are the prime numbers less than 10. So yes or no, Nana? Yeah, yes. So these are all well-defined objects, and the collection of well-defined objects is called as a set. Which are not well-defined objects? Let us discuss about them. For example, if I say all the beautiful flowers in the garden. All the beautiful flowers in the garden means in the garden there will be many flowers. So if I like two types of flowers, the other person may not like the same two types of the flowers. He may like other flowers. So there is a change in that consideration of beautiful flowers. I am considering two kinds of flowers as beautiful flowers, whereas other person will consider, so other than those two flowers, he will consider two other more flowers as beautiful. So here, person to person, that beautiful flowers are changing. So here those are not well-defined objects. And similarly, the most brilliant person in the universe. So this is also, we cannot judge who is the most brilliant person in the universe, because some person may be clever in mathematics, or some person may be clever in science, some person may be clever in designing. So we cannot judge the person who is most brilliant in the universe. All these are not comes under definite objects. These are not well-defined objects. Now, let us talk about methods of representation of sets. Representation of sets. So there are two methods to represent the sets. Those are, first one is roster form or list form. So roster form or list form method, and second one is set builder form. Set builder form or rule method. So how many methods are there to represent the sets, Nana? There are two methods. First one is roster form or list form. The second one is set builder form or rule method. So let us discuss one by one. Let us talk about the first one. What is a roster form? So in this form, we'll write the elements by keeping commas, and we'll close them with the braces. Means here elements are nothing but objects. So objects are called as elements. So for example, I'm writing here in this method, objects will be listed with commas and they will be enclosed by braces. They will be enclosed by braces. So for example, I will write set of all natural numbers less than 5. Set of all natural numbers less than 5. What is the symbol for less than, Anna? So this is the symbol for less than. In place of less than, we can use this symbol. Set of all natural numbers. Without writing this less than, we can use this symbol. We can use this symbol. You can use symbol, this less than symbol directly. Okay, now? So this is the less than symbol. In place of less than, we can use this symbol. So set of all natural numbers less than 5. So we'll write. So which form it is? Roster form. Roster form means how we have to write the objects here. So we have to write the objects by keeping commas. So less than 5 means 1, 2, 3, 4. Only 4 natural numbers we'll get with this statement. Set of all the natural numbers less than 5. Those are 1, 2, 3, 4, because natural number starts from 1. So now, and we kept commas in the middle of those elements or objects, and after that we have to enclose with braces. Enclose with braces. So this is a roster form. This is the roster form of set. For example, all even numbers less than 11, all the even natural numbers less than 11. We know that natural number starts from 1 and up to 11 we have to consider. Among those we have to see how many even numbers are there. What do you mean by even numbers? The numbers which are divisible by 2, exactly. The numbers which will be divisible by 2, exactly, are called as even numbers. So what are those? Those will be 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. What is the next even number? Next even number is 12. But 12 is greater than 11, means more than 11. So, but we have to consider up to less than 11 only. So these are the elements in the set. Then how to represent this set? So we have to write the elements with the commas, and we have to keep braces to represent a set in roster form. This is how to represent the set in roster form. The next method is set builder form. So in this form, instead of writing the elements list, we list the property. We'll write the property. Based on that property, what are the elements we'll get? We'll identify in it. So for example, set builder form X such that X is odd number. X is odd natural number. And X less than 10. X less than 10. So this is the representation of set in set builder form. So here X, these two dots are there, no? These we'll call it as such that. X such that X is a odd natural number and X less than 10. So if you want to write it in set builder form, equivalent set builder form, this equivalent roster form for this set builder form is, so what are the elements you will get? Odd natural numbers less than 10. Odd numbers 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. So this is the equivalent set in the roster form to this given set builder form of a set. Did you understand or not? Okay. So one more example. So we can write set builder form like this also. Instead of these dots, we can write this like this. X such that X is equals to n square. X such that X is equals to n square, where n belongs to capital N and N less than 5. N less than 5. X says that X is equals to N square. N belongs to capital N, means here this small n is belongs to natural numbers and N is less than 5. So now what are the elements that you will get? So N less than 5 means in natural numbers, what are the numbers? 1, 2, 3, 4. We will get these 4 numbers only. But here set X is equals to N square. The elements that you will get here are, so 1 square and 2 square, 3 square and 4 square. Because up to N less than 5. So you can write it as, what is 1 square value, Nana? 1. 2 square value 4. 3 square value 9. 4 square value 16. Okay, so this is the set builder form and elements in that set if you write in roster form. Did you understand, all of you? Now let's discuss cardinal number of a set. Cardinal number of a set. So cardinal number of a set is nothing but the number of elements present in a set is called as cardinal number of a set. For example, let A is equals to, let A is a set with elements 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then cardinal number of this set denoted with N of A is equals to how many elements are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. N of A is equals to 5. So one more example. Let B is a set A, B, C, D. So what is the cardinal number of set B? N of B is equals to the number of elements present in this set. How many number of elements are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 elements are there. So N of B is equals to 4. This is how we have to write the cardinal number of a given set. The number of elements present in a set is nothing but the cardinal number of a set.